Meanwhile, Larry Boy was driving all over Bumbleyburg, searching for anything that looked like it came from outer space. Alfred yelled over the radio in the Larry Mobile. Just then, Percy P. spotted his friend Junior, but he wasn't very happy to see him.
Junior,
he yelled,
I just came from Laura's house, and she got in trouble for breaking your dad's bowling plate. Except she says she didn't break it. She says you did. Who's telling the truth?
Junior looked down nervously. Then he remembered what his new friend had told him and decided to make up another story. This time, he said that Laura's little brother Lenny broke the plate. And once again, the fib worked.
Her brother?
Yep, that's right. Lenny broke the plate. I'll tell you the whole story. It's Lenny's fault he broke the plate. He's very naughty. Just how it started all, he hated Bart Bugatti. He gave it to a crocodile that chewed it up for quite a while. It's Lenny's fault he broke the plate, it's true. And that's the tale I have to tell to you.
Whoa.
Percy mumbled as he walked away.
I didn't think Lenny was capable of that kind of violence.
This is great! It worked again, Fib!
Junior yelled, but when he turned toward his friend, he found himself staring into Fib's belly. Fib was now 6 feet tall.
You are growing!
Junior remarked.
Maybe I put on a few pounds,
said Fib.
But Junior, I will always be your little Fib.
Just then, Percy P. hopped back around the corner with Laura the Carrot and her little brother Lenny. Junior was glad to see his friends, but he could tell they were not glad to see him.
If you need me, I'll be over here.
Fib whispered as he disappeared into the alley. Junior's friends were angry. Laura was mad that Junior lied about her. Lenny was mad that he lied about him. And Percy was mad that Junior had lied about both his friends. They told Junior that these weren't little lies. They were whoppers. One more time, Junior tried to get out of trouble by making up a story. This time, he said that space aliens had broken the plate.
Funny, I just saw that same thing happen in a movie,
Percy yelled.
That's another lie!
Just then, they heard the sound of giant footsteps in the alley. Junior turned around just in time to see Fib step into the street. He was as tall as a building. Fib reached down with a huge hand and plucked Junior off the sidewalk.
What are you doing?
Junior asked.
Don't worry, Junior,
Fib replied.
A little Fib couldn't hurt anybody, right?
Fib laughed wildly and stomped off down the street, taking Junior with him.
Why are you doing this to me? I thought you were my friend.
Junior cried out.
That's the thing about Fibs, Junior.
The monster bellowed.
We grow. Now that I'm big, it's my turn to call the shots. And you belong to me.
Just then, the Larrymobile spun around the corner.
Drop the asparagus!
Yelled our plunger-headed hero. The monster turned and headed for the Bumbleyburg Water Tower. Surely Larry Boy could never get him up there. As Fib carried Junior up the tower, Alfred told Larry Boy he had made some changes to the Larrymobile that might help.
You have?
Larry Boy asked.
I like to tinker in my spare time,
Alfred said. Alfred had Larry Boy drive straight at the water tower as fast as he could. Just as he was about to run out of road, Larry Boy pushed a button and wings popped out of the Larrymobile. It was now the Larry plane.
So this is what you do in your spare time,
Larry Boy remarked as he soared into the sky. Meanwhile, on the water tower, things weren't going very well.
Even a little lie can get really big, really fast,
the monster yelled.
And a big lie can just swallow you up. And Junior, you made a really big lie.
Junior's friend was really a big lie. But was the lie really going to swallow him? Larry Boy knew he had to act fast. So heading straight for the monster, he jumped out of the plane. The lie was ready, though, and caught him in a huge hand. Now he had Junior and Larry Boy. Larry Boy called Alfred on his belt radio.
I think now would be a good time for you to tell me how I can stop this lie,
he said. Alfred checked the computer.
According to my calculations,
he answered,
you can do nothing.
Larry Boy couldn't believe his ears.
Nothing?
He yelled. They were in big trouble. If Larry Boy couldn't stop the lie, they'd be eaten for sure.
Which one of you guys should I eat first?
The lie bellowed. Just then, Larry Boy's radio crackled to life.
I made a discovery!
Alfred shouted.
You cannot stop the lie, but someone else can.
What?
Larry Boy asked, but Alfred didn't know yet. His computer was still working on it.
Sort of look like candy.
The monster rumbled and lifted Larry Boy toward his huge mouth.
Alfred!
Screamed our hero.
We have no time!
It's leaking!
Alfred yelled back as the computer began drawing a picture. The answer was coming, but was it too late? Larry Boy was almost in the lie's mouth.
Goodbye, bubbly bird!
He moaned. Back in the Larry cave, Alfred stared at the screen. His eyes widened. It was Junior! He yelled into the radio.
Junior can stop the lie!
Junior thought hard. How could he stop the lie? Then it came to him.
I did it!
He screamed.
I broke the plate!
Suddenly, the monster started shrinking like a leaky balloon. The more Junior confessed, the more the lie shrunk. With a final pop, the lie vanished completely.
I'm really sorry about your plate,
Junior told his dad as Larry Boy lowered him to the ground.
I'm sure it was an accident,
his father said.
I just wish you would have told me right away.
Junior said he had learned that even though telling the truth isn't always the easiest way, it is always the best way. Elsewhere in the city, another fib landed in another neighborhood, looking for someone to help him grow.
Alfred, I've got work to do. Consider our game postponed.
What kind of weapon systems do we have?